baby that's on the close to the road. But what we're going to try and do is head to a little termite mound that's not far here. Get up onto the mound because it looks like they're heading in this direction. So if we get up onto the mound, it'll be a really nice safe place for us to be. So rather than being right out in the open, which you can see there's some of the big females starting to come out now as well. And they're all starting to appear towards the road. Now, isn't this incredible? Being with elephants on foot has got to be one of the most special things. It's incredible just to sit and listen to them breaking branches, talking to one another, and just generally going about their business. Now, from where we are now, they haven't seen us or heard us, but we are quite out in the open, so I just want to see which way they're going. Seems like they might be going this way, so let's rather change direction here, Seb, and get onto a different mound. Now, the reason why we go onto termite mounds is because termite mounds afford us a sort of a bit of a height, and so with an elephant, when you get a little bit higher than them, if they do detect us, then it means that they will be not as sort of aggressive towards us. They get a little bit more intimidated by the fact that you're a bigger being than what they are. Now, Seb, you just caught this. I just go back a little bit. So I'm just going to hold that for you. There we go. So, as I was saying, also the other thing about getting onto a mound is a mound means that we don't make too much of a scent. Our scent is quite high then, and it becomes difficult for the ellies to be able to hear us. Now, I think I can spot a quite a big bull in here as well, which is going to be amazing if they head in this direction. So, let's see if we can't get up here. Seb, I think if you can try get up a little bit further. Now, our view from here might be obscured a little bit for now, but they are heading in this general direction, so hopefully they'll end up coming fairly close and we'll be able to get to see them. But isn't this amazing? What an incredible start to the day. You can see the big bull there, busy scenting the female, so it's a nice sort of size comparison between female and male. So, Tyler, you're wondering if the ellies are more likely to charge with babies. Well, yes, the females will be very protective with their babies, and that's why you want to be very careful and make sure you don't get in between the herd and between the female and her young one, because they will do anything to protect their babies. So it is something that you've got to be a bit careful of, and that's why we're trying to use the wind, a little bit of cover, also get ourselves a little bit higher so that we can see what's going on and we're not right in the way of these elephants. If we had stayed on the road, they would have certainly seen us. They've still got quite good eyesight. At the end of the day, their sense of smell and hearing is very, very good, so better for us just to take a bit of cover that we can actually see what's going on and watch them start coming out of the bush. And like I said, they are heading towards us, so we should be able to see them nicely from a very safe perspective. But an elephant mother that is scorned is probably one of the most dangerous animals out here. You've got to be very careful with elephant females. Look at the size of the male that's coming through there now. He is huge. Now, I can't see if he's in must from here. He might be. Generally, when the male is in must, it's when he's actually looking for females and searching, trying to find a mate. And there's probably a female in here that's in estrus. I've seen him with his trunk touching multiple females between the legs. And basically what he's trying to do is sniff and smell if she is in heat by using his trunk. So I'm sure there is a female that is in heat. There's also lots of little babies that are moving around as well. And like I say, it looks like they're going to come fairly close to where we are, which is absolutely incredible. The other nice thing is if Byron is heading towards the hyena den, these elephants are also making their way straight that side, so he might get lucky with hyenas and then this elephant herd bumping into the den at some stage as well. But I can't tell you how special this is to be sitting with a herd of elephants in the early morning and just watching them go about their business. At this stage, they don't know we're here. They're still going about feeding, and that's always a great sign. When you walk into a herd of elephants, you can watch their sort of feeding behavior. As soon as they stop feeding, you know that they've detected something and they're not really that happy about what's going on. But when you see elephants feeding, their ears flapping gently, cooling themselves, you know that you're in a good place and that they haven't spotted you, so it's a good thing. So, Kylie, you're wondering if elephants really are that dangerous. Well, Kylie, they are indeed. I actually know of somebody that was killed in the Sabi Sands by an elephant. She was unfortunately got between a calf and a mother, and she was killed in quite quick time as well. So I do know somebody personally that has been killed by them, but there are multiple cases of elephants attacking people, and generally when you get an animal of that size attacking someone, it's such an unfair contest that no one really survives them. It's very seldom that somebody will survive an elephant attack, but they are incredibly dangerous when they feel like they're threatened. You must remember that they see people as a predator, and so when they see predators, it's like lions, they chase them away. The thing is a lion is much faster than what we are. We are not even as fast as what an elephant runs. And so if an elephant does decide to chase you and you don't get away, you're going to be in big, big trouble. And when there's a 4 or 5 ton animal that's deciding that you are a threat, it really can do quite a bit of damage. They've got this massive trunk that they use sometimes to sort of bat things away, and then they've got those tusks that they can gore, and I've seen them also, they stand on things and try and sort of kick and maim. So they are an incredibly dangerous animal. You've got to be very, very, very careful of elephants. And in fact, when you're training to be a guide, the first few times you do bushwalks, you try and avoid elephant herds in particular. Elephant herds are really sort of reserved until you've got a bit of sort of knowledge and you know what you're doing, and you've walked a few of the dangerous animals like buffalo and rhinos and those kind of things, and then you start to go up onto elephant bulls, who are a little bit more sort of easygoing. And then once you've sort of learned how to deal with that, then the sort of last prize is big herds of elephants, because the babies are around and the females can be so aggressive. Well, Gail, I think that's it's a difficult question to answer, because it's a question that depends on the circumstances. But you're wondering how close is too close. Like I say, it depends on the conditions that you're in, depends on the individual animals that you're with. Certain herds are more relaxed than others, same as with males. It depends on how the wind is blowing, what cover you've got. But, you know, as a guide, you tend to try and kind of not disturb an animal. So I think when you get to a point where the animal is right on top of you and it notices you there, then you probably are too close. Well, that's how I feel about it anyway. But at the moment, I mean, we are, I would say, about 100 meters, maybe a little bit less, from where these elephants are, which is a really, really safe distance. Even if I was with guests, I would be happy with the distance that we're at. Sometimes we do get elephants coming a little bit closer, and because it's just the three of us, it's okay if they come a little bit closer, because we don't have to worry too much about too many people, and we can find ourselves a safe point, like a termite mound, like us, and everyone can fit on top of it. But yeah, I'd say probably once an elephant starts getting past 40 meters, that's when you start to be a little bit more concerned. And I mean, I have had elephant bulls that have walked within sort of 10 meters of me, which is quite something. I mean, it's a really difficult thing to deal with, and you've got to be so careful with something like that. And like I say, I don't really like to do it, because I don't like to influence the behavior of the animal in any way, or make them in any way wary or cautious of us. The idea is just to view them, get a beautiful sighting like we're having now, and then to get out without them actually knowing that you were there. So that's the kind of idea behind it. But like I say, it's a circumstantial thing. Each time is different, and some days you'll be able to get to 100 meters and they'll already start picking you up because the wind won't be in your favor. Some days you'll be able to get to within 20 meters and it will be absolutely fine. So it just depends. But where we are now is absolutely perfect, and we've got this perfect point of safety. And like I say, they are slowly drifting towards us. I can see one that's now probably about 40 meters away, but it's perfectly fine. So, Dave and Douglas, you're wondering how big that male elephant is. Well, I mean, it's difficult to say exactly how big he is, but I would say that he's probably weighing already about 5 tons. He's quite a big guy. He's got a sort of very big head already. His temples are sinking in, which means he's an older male. But I would say about 5 tons. And then in terms of shoulder height, easily I would say 3.5 meters at the shoulder, or 3 meters I would say at the shoulder. That would be about my sort of guess. It really is quite difficult because of where we are now. We're on a quite a tall termite mound, so we're almost looking down at these elephants, which gives you a bit of a sort of a squashed comparison of size. You don't get the true size because you're not at the same level as them, but I would say he's probably about 5 tons, which is a big male. I mean, generally male elephants don't get too much bigger than that. Some of the males in Kruger will get to 6-7 tons, but it's very seldom. But he's a really big boy and seems to be quite a gentle giant. He hasn't made too much of a fuss. You can see the females are fairly comfortable with his presence at this stage. There's not too much vocaling or sort of any noises, so yeah, everything looks fine with him, and like I say, a gentle giant. Right, so we're going to carry on sitting here because these elephants are just drifting closer, and it really is so nice just to be sitting with them. And while we do that, I believe Byron has